Hello and welcome to the Rock Bowl. It is senior day here at Loras College, located in Dubuque, Iowa. I'm Hugh Maloney, and joining me, as he has been this whole season, is Adam Rodriguez. And Adam, how are you feeling about today?
You know, super excited. Like you said, senior day here, last home game for sure. Last one for us to call.
Mm-hmm, it is.
It's going to be a super exciting one. You know, Loras looking to get above 500 here. And both teams, strong offensive players, a couple of key guys that we'll talk about here in just a bit. But, yeah, I'm super excited for this one.
Like Adam said, the Duocs looking to get above 500 coming in today. They are 4-4, taking on the Simpson Storm, who are coming in today at 3-5.
Simpson won the toss and elected to receive.
So Simpson will be getting the ball to start here. And Adam, who are some of the key players for the Simpson Storm offense?
Yeah, absolutely. We were looking at it beforehand. You want to start with their quarterback, Jay Jensen III, averaging 305 yards a game. That's very, very nice for the Storm for sure. I mean, the one thing you want, you obviously want to change is those 13 interceptions on the air. But a 63% completion, it's pretty solid. And then his go-to guy, Reed Worth, averaging 117.9 yards a game, 118 with 12 touchdowns. It's kind of like Loras.
Yeah.
The quarterback-receiver duo you want to see get hot right out of the gates. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure we'll be saying their names quite a bit today.
And, Adam, with the Simpson Storm coming on to start on offense, who are going to be their starters on offense?
Yeah, absolutely. With the Storm, their starters on offense. We'll start with that front line. You got number 58, Mason Brulette, number 76, Josh Stokes, number 62, Josh Bream, number 70, Cole Henricks, number 52, Lucas Bartichek. At the tight end position, number 18, Tristan Bushi. At the running back, Desmond Alexander. Quarterback, like we said, Jay Jensen, his top guy. At the receivers, number 8, Reed Worth, number 2, Cameron Jones, and number 16, Cole Staska.
Duhawk defense will have their hands full coming into this game and through the whole thing as we are getting prepared for kickoff, as Scott Talmadge has everything lined up and he is good to go. Last home game for the Duhawks 2023 season is underway as Talmadge kicks this one back to the Storm's 10-yard line. They're going to elect to return this one here as they make a cut at the 25 and brought down close to the 30-yard line. Good play there for the Storm, getting above to the 30, as that brings out the offense that Adam just told you about. And like Adam said, Jensen will be the quarterback, mainly the passing quarterback. They do like to run a lot of two quarterbacks. Gerard Fisher is the other quarterback that he gets in there. He's played 8 games, and he's more of the rushing quarterback from what we've seen in our stats and from warmups earlier today. Bushy motions across as Jensen throws this one out to the flat. That is his man Worth right off the start for a gain of 1.
Yeah, and absolutely. If you're a Storm fan there, that's exactly what you want to see. Like I said, you want to get those two going right out of the gates. And for Worth to come down with 1 completion already, it's going to be – expect a big game out of him for sure.
Jensen in the backfield with his running back, number 9, Danny Rankins Jr. Jensen hands it off to him, cuts it up to the left, looking to make something happen. He's brought down for a loss by the Duhawks. That is number 22, Dawson Charlie. As looks like Charlie's a little slow to get up here after making the tackle. Second play of the game, the graduate student linebacker, number 22, Dawson Charlie out of Janesville, Iowa, goes down, looks like with an ankle injury, got wrapped up on the tackle.
Absolutely. I mean, if you're a Duhawk fan, that's one of the one guys you don't want to see go down. I mean, obviously, you don't want anyone to go down with injury, but tied for second on the defense with tackles with 43. Him and Brett Bauer both 43. So definitely a huge key piece to this Duhawk defense that is usually very, very strong.
And something that we mentioned earlier, I mean, not earlier, we were talking about earlier pregame was that Andrew Hayfold, their senior linebacker, is out too. So now Duhawks are down two linebackers as Jensen rolls out to his right, and he's looking for his wide receiver, number two, Cameron Jones. That ball was batted down by the Duhawks. Looks like that was number 49, Michael Mixon, on the coverage. And that brings up fourth down. So a Duhawks defense causing a three and out, forcing the Storm to bring on their punter, number 87, Braden Draper.
Yeah, and I mean, that's what, for the Duhawks, that's what you want. You want your defense to get going early, get some three and outs quick. They bring a lot of energy to this Duhawks squad as a whole. So to get a three and out right away, it's huge for this team.
The punt is up and it's away, and it's a spiraling punt here as that one takes a bounce at the 40-yard line. It'll kick out of bounds at the 25, and that is where the Duhawk offense will take over, Adam. And what is this Duhawk offense that is pretty high power looking like to start today?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, first off, you want to talk about their duo. We mention all the time England and Monty Brown, get them going early. But with them on that front line is number 66, Cato here, number 78, Caden Griffiths, number 62, Connor Durden, number 65, Justin Hayes, number 72, Caden Karnas. At the tight end position is number 84, Owen Livy. And at the running back, number 2, Johnny Kaysen. Like I said, quarterback Evan England, and his receivers, number 13, Jaheim Haynes, number 81, Michael Crawford, and number 5, Monty Brown.
As England throws it right to Monty Brown off the start. First play in the Duhawks flip field position, going onto the Storm's 41-yard line after that one. And just like what you said, Adam, and you'll see the replay right here, Evan England to Monty Brown, just one heck of a connection. It's been that way all season and for their whole career as they will be going to their senior year after next week's game. As England dumps this one out into the flat to Kaysen, who gets a good gain here, and then he's brought down past the 35-yard line. We'll call it the 34.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know about you, but I love how the Duhawk offense looks. Obviously, that first play, but they're looking like they have a ton of energy behind them. Really one of the first games in a while where you see all the energy in both sides of the ball. Typically, it's the defense that has to try to pick up some energy, but both sides coming out hot early.
England, plenty of time in the pocket. He's going to decide to keep this one as he tucks it, and he's got a lane.
Oh, yeah.
Down the sideline. Yahtzee, touchdown, Duhawks. Evan England running it in for a 31-yard touchdown. And that's Evan England's poise there in the pocket.
Yes.
Everything started to come down on him, and, you know, people weren't open. And he just tucked it and ran for a touchdown.
Yeah, props to the rest of the guys on offense, giving him those blocks to create that open hole, give him a lot of green, and then find the end zone. Obviously give the Duhawks hopefully a 7-0 lead here with Talmadge. But, yeah, just props to the rest of the team to create that wide open gap for him.
Talmadge's kick is up and no good.
No good.
The missed kick here from Talmadge keeps it a 6-0 game. As you see England's rush here, you know, just like we said, he's poised, and then he tucks it and runs it in, and right just, there, the rest is history. Nothing but turf, and there's a block from Monty Brown right there. Three plays for the Duhawks and a touchdown. I think Coach Helminiak would be happy with that for the rest of this game.
Absolutely, yeah. If that's how the offense looks the entirety of this game, then yeah, I think Helminiak will be just fine. He'll probably sleep real nice if that's how it goes. And it's promising going into Co next week, a huge one against Co College. If this is how the offense is looking for that game, it could be a very close matchup for sure.
And Co, a very, as you see the Rock Bowl there, it's pretty packed as usual, as it has been most this season.
Yes.
Fans have been showing out very well. Like you said, the Duhawks play Co next week, and last week Co took on Luther, and the score was 64-2, or it was 62-2, but the Co-Hawks beating the North, only allowing 2 points, as the kick away from Talmadge is here, and he's brought down behind the 25-yard line. Good tackle there for the Duhawks, and that looks like it was number 48 for the Duhawks. Paul Rasp, the sophomore defensive back out of Lockport, Illinois. As the Storm offense comes back onto the field, Jensen is the quarterback. As he's going to hand this one off in a little bit of an end around.
Oh,
and that one's blown up behind the line of scrimmage by the Dewhawks. A great play there for the Dewhawks. And that was number 56, Jonah Clark, making a play. Dewhawk defense coming out, proving a point here in these first four plays that they've been on the field. Alexander in at running back now for the Storm as Jensen hands it off to Alexander. Alexander spin move and he goes nowhere. Two plays in a row, the Dewhawk front seven have been making plays.
Yeah, again, and like I said, it's a lot of energy out of this Dewhawk defense for sure, and we're seeing they're making it real tough for the Storm to really get anything going, especially on the run game. Obviously, we've only seen the one completion, but the run game being stopped fairly easy, yeah. You could say, right now.
And that was number 40, Henry Ivers, the freshman linebacker out of Oak Lawn, Illinois, who made that stop there for the Dewhawks, which brings up third and 15 now for the Storm, as Jensen's going to have to pass this one as he's hit as he throws. And that was my goodness, a one-handed snag by the freshman Henry Ivers, who is filling in for Andrew Hafel and Dawson Charlie. What a play.
Oh, my.
Henry Ivers making a name for himself these past two plays. And oh, my gosh.
Oh, absolutely.
Sports Center top 10, dare I say?
I'd get behind it for sure.
Mm-hmm. That was a heck of a play.
Easily in the middle of the pack, top 10 easily. Play right there.
Pistol formation now is England. Three-step drop back, looking to throw this one deep. He's got Monty Brown open, and Monty Brown catches it for a touchdown. Yahtzee, touchdown, Dewhawks. Dewhawks, four plays, two touchdowns.
What a ball.
That is some, high scoring. You know, we keep that trajectory every two plays you score a touchdown. I'd say that'd be a lot of points today.
Yeah, I'm no mathematician, but I think I'd agree there.
I'm not even going to try to do the math.
I think I'd agree. I think it would be quite a few points for the Dewhawks. But, I mean, fantastic ball from England. Holy smokes. And then Brown, just that
what we've seen all year, really. Yeah. Just making plays.
Able to get up and grab it and – oh, going for two here again. Back to 14.
England and Kaysen in the backfield. Haynes and England. He's going to go to England here. And England throws it to Brown. And it's just Monty go up and catch that ball, really. Doesn't really feel like a 50-50 ball when you're throwing it up to Damani Brown. More like an 80-20.
Yeah, right.
As the Dewhawks jump up to a 14-0 lead here. As here is the replay for the two-point conversion. As Monty Brown is limping on the sideline, it looks like here.
He was a little... pass here to Monty Brown. And England not really even looking at anyone else.
Yeah.
Got the snap off and immediately looked to Monty and just tossed it his way, knowing he was going to go up and grab it.
Some elite ball placement, too.
Oh, yeah.
Damani Brown... two receptions, 66 yards, and a touchdown so far. Can't be too mad with those numbers.
No, absolutely not.
Having two receptions, and we're only about 4 minutes into this one here. As Talmadge is back to kick this one away for the Dewhawks. Alexander and Rankins back to return. This one is Alexander, and Alexander cutting it to the right as he's still on his feet past the 25. And it looks like this one will be marked about the 27-yard line. As here comes the Storm offense once again. And Adam, like you said, Jensen... coming today, 13 interceptions. That one right there, his 14th. I mean, can't completely blame him. He got hit as he threw it, so obviously that takes a little bit of the power off the throw. But 14 interceptions and 24 touchdowns. Jensen's looking to throw this one deep to Worth. just out of his reach. There's Zacchaeus Knighton on the coverage for the Duhawks.
Yeah, just, yeah, like you said, just out of reach, and it looked like Worth definitely had a step on Knighton there, so Worth, it would have been a huge gain, obviously, but not a bad ball from Jensen whatsoever. Good to see him just airing it out, especially after throwing that interception.
Staska, Worth, and Jones are the receivers in for the Storm as Jensen looking deep here, and he's got a man who catches it for the first down after it looks like a blown coverage there by the Duhawks.
Yes.
Cameron Jones with the reception there for the Storm. As the Storm looking to move the pace here, catches Duhawk defense off guard as Brett Bauer, the safety, on coverage there for the Duhawks.
Yeah, again, another good ball there from Jensen. That one, obviously, right on the money.
Jensen handing this one off to Rampkins Jr. as he's brought down after a short game. Looks like there's a little bit of extracurricular activity going on down there after that play. Nico Jamilo on the tackle there for the Duhawks. Same personnel in for the Storm. Robinson, Staska, and Bickham in. As they hand this one off to Rankins once again. And that one, good for a gain of around 5 yards there. Making this a much more manageable third down now for the Storm. Third and four on the Duhawks 35-yard line. That reception by Jones to flip the field position was 34 yards there, officially. Riley Hayes checked in at halfback. They hand it off to Hayes. Hayes running towards that first down marker. We'll see where the officials spot it. And it looks like it'll be fourth down. As it looks like the Storm will be going for it here as they elected to run it on the third and four. As Jones checks out of the game for the Storm. And in comes for him, I believe that was number 86, Matthew Carr. It looks like the Storm are going two tight ends here, empty backfield. Yep. Hayes motions to Jensen. They hand it off to Hayes on a jet sweep. Hayes looking to cut it up, and I believe he got that first down.
Yeah. Believe so.
So the Storm convert on the fourth and inches as that keeps the chains moving.
Yeah, just a good drawn-up play there. Hayes able to just kind of force his way through, absorb the contact, and really force to get the first down there. That's a huge fourth down conversion for the Storm.
Alexander is the halfback now for the Storm. As Jensen drops back, looking to air this one out left side of the field. He's got a man on jump ball, and that ball's incomplete. And looks like there'll be a pass interference on Zacchaeus Knighton is what I can only assume that is. Coles, as there you hear the official call, pass interference on Zacchaeus Knighton. Cole Staska, the intended receiver on that play for the Storm. Daska, Alexander, Worth, and Jones are the personnel in there for the Storm, and Jensen is at quarterback. So there's a little bit of confusion going on here.
And I got to say, if you're the Storm offense, you definitely have to do what you can to get into the end zone here. Obviously down 14-0 and quick 14-0 for sure. Just get some momentum back on their side, because obviously it feels like it's a ton of momentum on the Duhawks side, especially after the first touchdown, interception, then the touchdown right after it.
As we are ready to get back into play here, shotgun formation for the Storm. Fakes the screen, he hands it off to Alexander, and he gets a good push there as he kept those legs turning. Gain of five. Second and medium now for the Storm. Duhawks with eight in the box right here. As Jensen drops back, as he's looking to the corner of the end zone here for Jones, and that ball is going to be incomplete out of the end zone, let him a little bit too far.
Yeah.
Ran out of real estate.
Absolutely no. Jones definitely had a step on the defense there on the coverage, and like you said, just too hard from Jensen. It was a good ball, but obviously just let him a bit outside.
Third down and six now for the Storm. As Hayes has checked in at running back once again. Duhawks send five, and Jensen gets it out quick over the middle as he's staying on his feet, and the refs will rule forward progress has stopped after the first down was gained. And the Storm are going quick here. Try to catch the Duhawks off guard. That was the tight end. Tristan Bushy with the reception there. First down. They hand this one off to Hayes. Hayes looking to get in the end zone. He's stopped short by the Duhawks.
Again,
looks like that was Brett Bauer in on the stop.
Really got to do whatever they can to just punch it right in the end zone here. I mean, obviously close enough to where they definitely could, but just got to get some momentum on their side for sure.
Storm staying in that shotgun formation. The tight end Bushy lined up to the left. As Jensen looking out quick. Oh. And that's his man, Reed Worth, with a nice move off the line for the touchdown. As that gives the Storm some momentum here, getting on the board, making this a 14-6 game before the extra point attempt by Michael Baumhoffner.
Yep, for just said it. There's Worth's 13th of the season, and just you said the move there had night and pretty lost right off the line.
Baumhoffner's kick is up, and it is good, making this a 14-7 game. As the Storm respond after the interception by Ivory, and here's the touchdown pass to Worth. It was a key night on the coverage, and Worth just had a nice double move there to get open in the back of the end zone. As there you see that Duhawks return team. They didn't get a spark going here. Place kicker for the Storm is Micah Baumhoffner, who just kicked his extra point through the uprights. Back to return for the Duhawks is senior Harrison Willis, as well as, looks like that's number 19, Brian Filosa, a freshman wide receiver from Elmhurst, Illinois. Ryan Filoso, back to return for the Duhawks with Harrison Willis. Kick is away, and this is a low one, as Harrison is going to let this one bounce out of bounds for a touchback. And then the Duhawk offense coming on the field to try to respond as you hear the coaches asking to get it on the near hash.
Yep. Again, I'd be interested to see if the Duhawks get the run game going at all here. I mean, obviously the passing game's working right now, but only the one rushing attempt.
I mean, they've only ran four plays, though.
Yeah, the one rushing attempt was England, and we saw how that ended with a touchdown.
Jamel Briz checked into the game as England is going to keep this one once again. His second rush of the game as he's knocked out of bounds, and no flags. England knocked out of bounds after a gain of four, making this second and six. Jamel Britt has checked into the game for the first time today at halfback. Pistol formation for the Duhawks. England get this one out quick to Jaheim Haynes. Haynes almost breaks that one free for a touchdown as he's brought down at the 46-yard line as the Duhawks approach midfield.
Yeah, you said it. He breaks out of that first one, stays on his feet. He had no one in front of him. I wouldn't be surprised if we'd be saying a Duhawk touchdown there.
JB motions next to England. England QB draw here, waiting for the holes to develop as he's cutting this one back up that left side. England runs this one out of bounds at the 38-yard line. Excuse me, the 42-yard line. Brown, Haynes, Crawford, and Couch are the receivers in for the Duhawks. England dropping back, has all day. He's looking deep for Monty Brown. Another jump ball.
Oh, my
God. Monty Brown. Yahtzee touchdown, Duhawks. I mean, come on.
Oh, my goodness.
It just isn't fair at this point. He had two men on him. He jumps over the first one and breaks through the second one. I mean, it's just
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my gosh. Like a cheat code.
Kidding me.
Like a cheat code.
Gotta be kidding.
Monty Brown's second touchdown reception of the game. And then Duhawk offense is clicking on all cylinders right now as there's Monty Brown, who just broke the all-time touchdown receptions leader and the single season touchdown receptions last week as Talmadge's kick is up. And this one's good, giving the Duhawks a 21-7 lead. As here comes the replay. As the England just had all day. And, one man jumped over. And then another broken tackle.
I mean, there's really no words you can put there. Not fair is probably the best words to describe Monty Brown, basically. But again, just unreal athleticism for Brown, able to go up and grab that, which looked like he was going to land in the Storm's defender's hands, but Monty able to just rip it out, and then obviously just dragging that second tackle into the end zone.
And that right there is why Monty Brown is arguably the best receiver in the conference and one of the best receivers in Division III at the moment. As he has been dominating for the past two seasons now.
Yes.
Excited to see what comes next for him. As Talmadge is away to kick this one once again. Talmadge kicks this one, and Alexander's going to let it. Oh, stayed in bounds. Oh, official threw the flag a little late. I thought that one might have stayed in bounds. But that one goes out of bounds, and the Storm will take over at the 35. Official left the mic on there. It's a rarity that usually happens.
Yeah. But he was not happy with whatever.
Yeah.
The other refs had going.
Had to let him know. Storm have two running backs in the game. Hayes behind Jensen as Alexander motions behind him. They fake the handoff to Alexander. Jensen's looking to throw this one deep to Worth. And Worth had a touchdown and dropped it. Reed Worth. You don't see that too much.
No.
Out of the Storm's number one receiver, dropped a walk-in touchdown.
Absolutely. Definitely had a couple of steps there on, I believe it was Mikey Barber on him. But, yeah, right through the hands, and that probably would have been a Storm touchdown. Yeah. They probably would be coming out for the extra point as we speak.
Good play design there by the Storm on that one. They hand this one off to Alexander, and Alexander's got a hole as he stays on his feet past the first down marker. Excuse me, that was not Alexander, that was Rankins. Shotgun formation after the first down. They hand this one off to Rankins once again. And this one, a much less gain here. As that was Gemolo on the tackle for the Dewhawks in the backfield. Dawson Charlie back in the game for the Dewhawks. Looks like him and Nico Gemolo will be splitting up the middle linebacker duties here. Shotgun formation as Jensen takes a big drop back here as he fires this one up deep over the middle.
Oh,
that one is caught for the Storm touchdown. And that one right there, Reed Worth, his second one of the game.
Yeah.
And looks like it's a battle of the receivers right now.
Absolutely.
As Worth has two and Brown has two. And this looks like it'll be a shootout today, Adam.
Oh, I agree. And the passing games for both sides just on fire right now. And both duos that I mentioned heating up early. And it's, for both teams, it's exactly what you want.
Bomb Offner to kick this extra point up, and it is up. And it is good, the officials say. And that is a 21-14 game. As here is the replay. I mean, Jensen took a big drop back and
all the time in the world, too. And just Worth able to break that tackle with ease there. And, yeah, just find his way to the end zone. Like you said, his second one of the contest.
Comparing the receivers here, Damani Brown, 3 receptions, 108 yards with 2 touchdowns. His longest reception being 42 yards. And Worth, 2 receptions, 52 yards with 2 touchdowns. Both are on an incredible pace right now for the rest of this game.
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, Monty over 108, we could have both receivers over 100 easily.
Well, I mean, if this pace keeps up, statistically, Monty Brown is projected to finish with 400-plus receiving yards.
Yes, if he keeps going 100 by quarter, yes.
If we look at the math of this, as Harrison Willis is making a cut. Harrison Willis cuts it back down the right and brought down at the 41-yard line. Got me so excited, I stopped talking about math.
Yeah, it doesn't take you long to get off the
topic
of math.
No, it does not take me long to get off the topic of math. Just about anything could get me off that topic. As Kaysen Two-Way has checked in at halfback here. Brown, Haynes, Willis, and Crawford are the receivers as Willis motions across the line of scrimmage. The Dewhawks hand this one off to Two-Way Kaysen, and he is brought down eventually at the, looks like the 49-yard line. Good gain there, 7 for Kaysen. His first rush of the game.
I believe the first rush that wasn't England.
Correct, as England throws this one to Crawford, who gets held the way, and there is a flag thrown on the play. That was number 32, Juan Hernandez on the coverage there for the Storm.
Pass interference on the defense, number 32. At the 15-yard penalty from the previous spot, first down.
First down for the Dewhawks. As the pace for the Dewhawks has kind of slowed down here. And we're still only in the first quarter, and it's 21-14.
Very high offense powered quarter, that's for sure.
High octane, if you will.
Yeah.
We're getting into the big words today.
Yes, I like it. I like it.
Since that was in 15 yards of the throw, I believe they did spot of the foul for the pass interference here. As Willis once again motions across the line of scrimmage. They hand this one off to Two-Way, who's got nothing but room. Johnny Two-Way Kaysen has one man to beat, and he gets in. Yahtzee, touchdown, Dewhawks. Johnny Kaysen with the touchdown. I mean, he had nothing but daylight there after he got through that first hole. And that is Kaysen's first touchdown on the season. Way to go, Two-Way Johnny.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, props to the rest of the offense, giving him tons of room. Lots of great blocks, able to create that huge run for him and give the Dewhawks now possibly a 28-14 lead.
Talmadge to kick this one. Kick is up and no good.
No good.
As you see the rush there by Two-Way. Really, the only defender was the lineman there, and then out comes this lone safety here. As that was a 36-yard touchdown rush. As there you see him celebrating. Why not? First one of the season.
Yeah, absolutely. He could have just ran off out of the entire rock bowl, for all I care, for the first one.
Forrest Gump almost, like Forrest did. Once again, back to return for the Storm, Alexander and Rankins.
Desmond Alexander and Green Rankins back.
As Talmadge kicking it away now for the Dewhawks. Talmadge lined up as he gets ready to boot this one away. This one's a little bit of a pop-up here as that is Alexander on the return. He's blown up by the Dewhawks. Number 9 for the Dewhawks. I believe that is Jonah. Oh, excuse me. That's not Jonah. That's Cormac Flynn making the stop there for the Dewhawks. That brings up first down and 10 now for the Knights. Shotgun formation. Jensen fakes like he's going to throw and hands this one off, and going nowhere is the runner there for the Storm. And that one on the tackle there is number 18, Jonah Irving.
Yeah, this Dewhawk run defense is doing a fantastic job right now. Not letting anything big happen with the run, but obviously you want to see probably the Dewhawk passing defense now kind of lock in a little bit. Obviously the two touchdowns to Worth and then the couple big bombs that Jensen's throwing to his receivers.
Dewhawk send four here as Jensen rolls to his right, gets this one out quick, and Zacchaeus Knighton knocks that one up. And a very late flag coming into play here now. As Zacchaeus Knighton initially broke that one up. Looks like this one will be a pass interference.
Pass interference on the defense, number six. At the first down, at the spot of the pass.
Zacchaeus Knighton, second pass interference call of the game, is there. He is right there on your screen.
Yeah, you said definitely a late flag for sure. The play was pretty much dead, and then flag comes in. But, I mean, obviously you can see it on the screen. Knight not really happy with that one.
Hayes in at halfback. They hand it off to him. So he's brought down after a gain of two.
Riley Hayes on a carry.
Second and eight coming up from the Storm's own 34-yard line. As the Storm makes some subs here on offense.
This is by Nico Camilo.
Alexander and Jensen in the backfield. They motion a man in the back and they fake it to him and hand it off to Alexander, who's brought down for a loss of two. Brett Bauer with the stop.
Yeah, again, I mean, really this Duhawk defense just doing everything they can and really just not letting the running backs get anything going. They're getting a couple yards here and there, but no big plays like we saw from Kaysen for that touchdown. Yeah.
And the Duhawks' run defense has been not significantly better, but it has been better, more to say, than the pass defense has been all year. That front four have been working very hard all year to get those stops as Jensen's dropping back, and he's going to go to Worth, I believe. Oh, excuse me, that is Jones with the reception short of the first down marker. That brings up fourth and three officially, as Jones had a 7-yard reception there, and out comes the punt team for the Storm.
Well, your second punt this contest, if I'm correct.
You are correct. The punt is up. Oh, and it's a good one.
Really good punt.
End over end punt, and Monty Brown is going to elect to return this one, and he's just going to step out of bounds, and there is a flag on the play. And it looks like the guilty party will be the Duhawks. And looks like it's number 23, Carter Cahill, is who it will be on. Number 13, Jaheim Haynes on the hold there. And Jaheim didn't even look like he was in the vicinity of where that flag was thrown.
Yeah, I agree.
Shotgun formation, they hand this one off to JB, and JB brought down after no gain. Storm defense making a stop here, possibly flipping the field position after a great punt there. Six seconds left in the quarter. The Duhawks don't have to run a play. They run one anyways as England is going to get this one in the flat to JB. And JB picks up the first down after dishing out a little bit of a hit.
Yeah, I mean, you said it. And that's what we know JB as. He's definitely the enforcer of the two running backs out of him and Kaysen. And obviously you saw it there with that hit on the run.
Yeah, and Kaysen and Britt getting a lot more action this year, as well, mainly because they're juniors, but as well as they used to be kind of a three-headed monster a little bit last year with KP, Killian Pritchett, and then obviously Kaysen and Britt, the three running backs there. And KP got hurt early in the year, had to have a thumb surgery that kept him out basically majority of the year. So those two obviously having a bigger role, and they're really stepping up and producing. As at the end of the first quarter, the Loras College Duhawks 27, Simpson Storm 14. Adam, what did you enjoy out of that high, you know, packed
first quarter? Absolutely. I mean, obviously, I mean, there's two pretty obvious things there. Reed Worth, Monty Brown, the passing game from both sides. I mean, Jensen England having a fantastic game, and Monty and Worth also having fantastic games. Two touchdowns for both those guys. I mean, like, I mean, I mentioned it right at the beginning, get those guys hot and you're going to be very successful, and that's exactly what both squads are doing.
Makes for good TV as well.
Absolutely. Usually have to pay double for that kind of action.
Oh, I love the dodgeball reference. Thanks. I love it.
Appreciate it.
My Halloween costume I went as an
that
average Joe. Thank you.
Good.
Thank you. Evan England dropping back, moving to his right, and he's going to tuck this one as he evades the defender. And if you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a dodgeball. As he dodged the defender right there and went out of bounds for the first down. As England successful in the air and on the ground today, as he has 141 passing yards as well as 51 rushing yards.
Hey, what can he do?
It's a great question as he once again drops back as Duhawks lose the helmet and England slides. And looks like that was number 65, Kate O'Hare, lost his helmet there. And usually that's a sign of hands to the face, but there's no flag on the play. Excuse me, that was number 66, Kate O'Hare. England after that rush. Now up to 63 as he hands this one off to JB. And JB using those legs, keeping it turning and picks up the first down
goodness.
And keep on going, JB. As he flips the field position, the Duhawks are on the Storm 40. JB with a big carry there, picking up the first down for the Duhawks.
Yeah, get JB going. That energy is going to come soaring high, especially with
hand it off to him again. He's got a lineman blocking for him as he stiff arms out of bounds, and JB is cooking right now.
Yeah, gonna give him
as it looks like. Yeah, they're gonna give him a breather here as Kaysen comes back into the game, as well as Harrison Wills coming in for Owen Libby. Kaysen motions to the left of England. England, three-step drop back. He's pushed up in the pocket. He's looking to make something happen. He's going to decide to keep this one as he tucks it, and he tiptoes out of bounds on the sideline. Looks like officials are going to mark him out of bounds at around the five-yard line. Actually, exactly the five-yard line. As there's England once again, and he's about to be close to over 100 yards rushing.
Yeah.
He may very well have it at the end of this half.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And then
England's under center here, sorry, as he's going to throw this one to Crawford. And Crawford stays on his feet, and Crawford is Yahtzee! Touchdown, Duhawks! As the senior, Michael Crawford, it's a little bit of the McGregor walk there. Why not? Gets the touchdown for the Duhawks. And Duhawks are going to elect to go for two here. After the missed extra point from Talmadge, and I just had to interrupt you because that is the second time all year we have seen Evan England get under center.
That is true.
And the only other time before that was on a QB sneak. So I was awfully confused by seeing him under center.
Yeah, no, I agree. Not a typical sighting for sure.
Duhawks going to go for the two-point conversion here and make this a 35-14 game. England has to step up in the pocket, and he's going to try to scramble this one in, and nope. He will not get in, and he's going to take that one. He looks gassed.
Yeah, he does.
As here comes the replay. Like we said, Michael Crawford determined to get in that end zone.
Yeah, I mean, just a lot of – I mean, that's a gritty play right there for Crawford for sure. Like you said, determined is one way to put it. And he was going to get into the end zone one way or another.
Kind of describes his personality. He's a very determined young man. Puts in a lot of work both on and off the field.
Yes.
As the school spirit song is being sang right now, actually. How many words of the spirit song do you know? The school song?
It's going to be, this is bad, but I think I only know three words of the.
Okay, what are they? I'll test you on it.
It's Hail Lors Varsity.
That's exactly what I was going to say. That's all I know for it, too. And it's on the outside of the cap, and we just like, and we've been here for 4 years, and we just don't know it besides that part.
Yeah.
But it's okay, because I think that's all EJ knew as well.
That's all I know, and some members of my golf team, they typically like to say the Hail Lors Varsity and then follow it up with rah, rah, rah right after. So
yeah, as Alexander takes this
turn.
One, and he's going to cut this one back. Oh. Cut it back some more as he's at the 50 looking to make a juke and brought down after a good return past the 50. Looks like that is a 48-yard line. So maybe that will bring the Storm back into this, give him some more life here as they are down by 19 with 12:31 left to go here in the half.
Yeah, you said it. Hopefully give them some life. And, I mean, that's really what you need, just one big play, whether it comes from the defense, offense, or special teams like we just saw. And, I mean, that can just change the momentum at any given moment of any game, not just football.
Rankins, Haynes are the backs as Rankins motions behind Jensen, and they're going to hand this one off to Hayes. Hayes cuts this one back, and he's blown up at the line of scrimmage. Maybe behind it, Michael Nixon making a great stop there. As there he is on your screen. The junior linebacker from Evergreen Park, St. Rita High School. We've reached the 12-minute mark here of the first half as the Storm break the huddle and look to make a big play here. Duhawks sending five as Jensen gets this one out quick to Worth, who tiptoes out of bounds. Third down and five now for the Storm on the Duhawks 42-yard line. As defensive coordinator Greg Bauer is going to need a big stop here out of his defense. Jensen dropping back, gets this one out right at the sticks to Worth, who stays on his feet and is brought down at the 36-yard line.
I mean, who else would you expect that ball to go to on a much-needed conversion? Obviously, you got to go. Jensen goes right to his number one guy, Worth. Just to add on to the big day that he's already having.
So there you see the senior cornerback, Zacchaeus Knighton, who's honored today, as well as many of the other seniors that have provided so much to this Duhawk football program. Jensen hands this one off to Rankins. Rankins pouncing it out behind the line of scrimmage. Makes something happen. And he does the opposite of that. Makes something happen for the Duhawks. That is Gemolo on the tackle for the Duhawks. Nico's having himself one heck of a game.
Yeah, he is.
In this first half. Not even game, first half, I should say. He can add on to this. Both the linebackers, Nico and then Henry Ivers.
Yes.
And Henry, for being a freshman, has had, like I said, I mean, it kind of sounds like a broken record, but he's had a very good first half. He had a tackle for loss and that one-handed interception. Yeah.
The interception, absolutely. I mean, that was a huge momentum shifter. Yeah.
Jensen, quick drop back, gets it out quick. Oh, what a throw and what a catch.
Dot.
Good throw there by Jensen. That was to his target. That was number 16, Cole Staska.
Yeah, I mean, you said it. I mean, just a fantastic ball from Jensen. Just right into his hands, perfect, and just right over the defender. And now in the red zone, in fantastic position for a much-needed score.
As the Storm have entered the red zone, they're on the Duhawk 15-yard line here, first and 10. Jensen dropping back as he's pressured. Hit as he throws, and that one will go incomplete. Couple of Duhawks there on the pressure. Look like that's Henry Ivers once again in there for the Duhawks, as well as Brandon Phelps. Bring up second and 10 now for the Storm. Jensen right now 9 for 14, one interception, 137 passing yards with two touchdowns, as he hands this one off to Alexander, who had that big return to get them in this good field position, as he's brought down after a gain of a yard. Third and 9 for the Storm on the Duhawk 14-yard line as Sean Doyle and Elijah Dirtz check in now for the Duhawks. Checking in for Preston Petrusik and Emmett Finn are the ones who came out. Keep an eye on the top of your screens. That's where Worth is, and that's where Jensen's going, right at the sticks. Looks like he was short of them.
I believe so.
And the official is waiting for the official marking. Yep, it is fourth down here. That's a good tackle there for the Duhawks. That was number 19, Rashad Johnson, who's really stepped up his role this year, senior defensive back. And this brings up fourth down now.
Yeah, this is a much-needed conversion and a much-needed stop.
As Jones comes out and Matthew Carr comes in, and the Purple Chants are starting to murmur through the Rock Bowl. As this is a heavy formation lineup now for the Storm. They hand this one off to Hayes, and he gets the first down, it looks like.
He got it.
Bring the chains out. I would just love to see the chains come out right now. Oh, the chains are coming out.
Oh, wow.
Oh, first time we've seen this all year. Oh, this is going to be intense.
Yeah, it always
is. I live for this. I live for this.
It always is intense. Might as well use those.
I do have my binoculars. Thank you, Adam. Okay, let's look here. I'll give the play-by-play.
Oh, here you go. Right on your screen, too.
Okay. Oh, well, then why am I using my binoculars? It looks like he's short. Oh,
they gave it to
him. Okay, I just guessed there. I had no clue. I just guessed. I couldn't tell. The binoculars are actually a good idea because they helped until I looked down and then
until they're on
until
screen.
I like, you know, lost focus and all that jazz. First and goal here for the Storm on the Duhawks 5-yard line. Hayes is the back. Worth is at the top of your screen. And they elect to give it to Alexander, who is brought down from behind after looks like a gain of a yard. I believe that was Brandon Phelps on the tackle for the Duhawks. Coming from behind. Awfully fast from behind as well.
Yeah, he pretty much came out of nowhere, just spawned from behind.
Yeah, Alexander tried to make that cutback and to no avail. Staska and Worth are at the top of your screen as Jensen gets this one out to his tight end and just a little bit short. That was to Matthew Cart. Great play design there. Jensen just left it a little short. Pressure got in his face and just short-armed it.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, no other way, to put it. I mean, probably would have ended up being a touchdown. But, yeah, just good pressure, though, from the Duhawks to allow that short pass from Jensen.
Tristan Bushy has came back in at tight end. Once again, Worth, Staska, and Jones are bunched together at the bottom of your screen, and Alexander is the halfback as Bushy motions out to the left, and so does Worth go across the line of scrimmage. Jensen looking over the middle to Staska, and that one is incomplete. Zacchaeus Knighton on the coverage for the Duhawks, bringing up fourth and goal.
Yeah, it looked like Staska just kind of left the ground a little too late. The ball was over his head by the time he was leaving his feet to try to go up and grab that one. But, I mean, good coverage there from
That was a favorable matchup as well.
Yes.
For the Storm. Staska is listed at 6'3". Zacchaeus Knighton is listed at 5'9".
Yes.
It's a little bit of a height difference.
Yeah, I would say so.
As the Storm, second, fourth down of this drive. Can they go 2 for 2? They need to get in the end zone for it. They got 5 yards to go. Jensen dropping back. He's looking for Jones in the corner. That one's no good. The Duhawks get a stop on defense. Jensen was looking for Jones there in the corner of the end zone once again. This one no good. As you see Coach Bauer hyping his boys up. And there's the fans.
Yeah, again.
All bundled up. It's a little bit chilly.
Yeah.
Sun's out, but it's, you know, it's not bad.
When you're in the sun, it doesn't feel terrible, but the shade, then it kind of drops a little bit.
England hands this one off to JB. JB getting the Duhawks out of their own end zone shadow, giving them some breathing room. Second and 4 now after a 6-yard rush from JB. England hands this one off to JB. Nice little spin move. Bounces this one out for the first down, and then someone's brought down at the 20-yard line. Been seeing a heavy dose of Britt, as that has been working for the offense as he's been moving the ball with them. They fake the run to him as England's going to throw this one deep to Monty Brown. As that one is under the
and no, you did not. Oh my goodness, Damani Brown, stop it.
God. Stop it right now, young man.
This is insane.
It's like he's playing Madden on creative mode right now. Here's the replay.
That is ridiculous.
I think that's pass interference, but they didn't throw it anyways. But, I mean, still, what a catch. Damani Brown, come on.
Oh, my. I mean, good.
It's just gracious. Not fair. As England gets this one out quick to, I believe that's Jaheim Haynes for a gain of about 6 yards.
Yeah, I don't know, man. What a grab.
I don't know, man. That's just great analysis right there.
I don't know, man. I'm at a loss of words after that grab.
England dropping back once again. He's going to decide to keep this one. England cutting it up to the right as England gets the first down and is brought down at the, looks like that's the 23 or 22 yard line. As Owen Libby checked into the game at tight end. Damani Brown, that reception for him, around a 40-yard gain. We'll get the official number to you shortly. As they hand this one off to JB, who's hit initially and stays on his feet, but he's driven backwards. Looks like they'll be spotted at the line of scrimmage, though. As the players lost their helmet for the Storm. A 40-yard reception for Damani Brown on that previous catch that he had. Evan England, dare I say it, 9 for 9 on passing, 188 yards with 3 touchdowns. Also, it says the QBR is at 385.5. I mean, that's fairly good, I'd say. As England drops back, he gets this one out to Monty Brown, and ooh, that's a tough look for me right
that's
there.
Your fault.
As he is now 9 for 10.
The commentator jinx.
That is his first incompletion of the game. Bring up 3rd and 10.
That one's on you.
We've all been there. Pretty sure you did something similar earlier this year.
Probably.
I think it was on a kick. If my memory serves
me
correctly.
It was. Yeah. Yeah, I'll raise my hand to that one.
Yeah. Don't throw stones from a glass house. Shotgun formation, 3rd and 10. The Ducks are just going to hand this one off to JB, who's looking to get anything. And he does, as there's a flag thrown here. More than likely a hold on a play like that.
Flag on the play.
Holding on the Dewhawks, number 65, Justin Hayes, the sophomore offensive lineman from Norwalk, Iowa, and Norwalk High School. There he is on your screen right there. Next to the senior center, number 62, Connor Durden. As it is now 3rd and 20 for the Dewhawks. On the Storm 33-yard line. Brown motions. England is looking to throw it to Brown, short of the 6, and Brown gets the knee inbounds, making this a much more manageable fourth down, and it looks like Coach Helminiak's going to elect to keep the offense
keep
out
them.
There.
I mean, why not?
Yeah.
Good got it going right now.
That was a good catch by Brown, getting the one knee inbounds. This is now 4th and 1 for the Dewhawks on the Storm's 14-yard line. As England gets him to jump, he's got a free play. He's going to throw this one up to Couch. That ball is intercepted, but it does not matter as England drew him off sides with the hard count. The intended receiver there for England is number 83, Brock Couch, the freshman receiver out of Tarpon Springs, Florida. Alex Boyle was the name that was announced there over the stadium from Peoria, Arizona. But they could have said about anybody there on that defensive line as they majority of them jumped. As England fakes the handoff to Kaysen, throws to Couch, who catches it, but he's about a yard short. Brock Couch, the reception as England is knocked down on the throw. Duhawk's going to hurry up here. England going under center, third time all year. Possibly a QB sneak coming in here, and it is. And England cannot quite see from here, but wait for the officials as the helmet has been lost. Looks like he was marked short. Actually, I don't know if there's been an official mark yet. England lost his helmet. You can hear kind of the you can hear the talking going on down there. There's England. I didn't want to talk over that because I just kind of wanted to let everybody hear and have myself hear what was going on. There's Coach Helminiak elects to use his timeout. Is that why England does not have to come out of the game for this third down and a yard? As England, you know, obviously the starting quarterback. And Coach Helminiak had three to burn and 2:23 left in the half. Might as well use one here.
Yeah, why not? Why not?
I also don't think people were, not people, I don't think the Duhawk players and staff were overly happy that England's helmet came off from the bottom of the pile either, which you kind of hear over the mic down there. Third and goal here from the 1 yard line. They're gonna try to get to the power back, JB, who jumps. And he's not in. JB tried to jump over the pile. He stopped at the same spot the Duhawks were at earlier in the storm. Use a timeout here.
Timeout, Simpson. Their first in the half.
As now it's decision time for Coach Helminiak and his offense. And it looks like the offense, as of right now, is going to stay out there. See what Coach Steve Helminiak will have going on now here for the offense. Coach Helminiak in his 11th season as a head coach for the Duhawks, 33rd overall season coaching college football. And meanwhile, on the other side, we have a first year with the program, at least as a head coach, Reed Hoskins. So we have a coach in their first season with the team and then one in their 11th season. Fourth and goal from the one once again. Nine in the box for the Storm. England looking to throw this one to Monty Brown in the corner. Yahtzee! Touchdown, Duhawks! Monty Brown, three touchdown receptions on the game. As that is Monty's second game this season with three receiving touchdowns. He did it against Luther. As it looks like Duke's going to go for two. Monty Brown just needs one more receiving touchdown to tie the all-time, excuse me, not all the time, for the most touchdown receptions in a game, which is four. So if he gets two more, then he has that to his own name, and that will be his third record that he has achieved in this year alone.
Just a fabulous career for Brown.
England to Couch in the end zone, and two-point conversion. I almost said touchdown. Two-point conversion brought Couch to England, as Couch is a little slow to get up off the turf, as here is that throw from England to Brown. And once again, just that's actually a very good place, a very well-placed ball, excuse my grammar. And just once again, Monty's showing those good hands, and rarely do you see him catch the ball with his body. Trust those hands a lot.
Oh, yeah. You said, I mean, if you see like a body catch, it's usually most likely going to be on a close ball, and typically on a slant form. But, yeah, just fantastic hands. I mean, we've seen it all game. We saw it on the bobble catch for that huge 40-yard reception. But, yeah, I mean, just unreal athleticism and just good concentration to just come away with that ball. And a fantastic thrown pass from England for sure. I mean, never even looked away from it. Immediately was going to Monty right off the snap.
Evan England and Damani Brown are dialed into each other today. Evan England, 216 passing yards after that drive. Damani Brown, 164 receiving yards with three touchdowns. And Evan England also 101 rushing yards in the first half as well. So 317 total yards so far in the first half for Evan England alone. And 5 total touchdowns so far in the first half. As the score is 41-14 with 2:08 left to go in the first half as Talmadge kicks this one away. And Alexander is going to let that one bounce in for a touchback. Bringing out the Storm offense, who has gone dormant here a little bit in the past second quarter.
Yeah. No, yeah, you said it. The defense for the Duhawks really slowing down the Storm offense. Simpson looked really, really good in that first quarter and a little bit in early in this second quarter. And like you said, just kind of slowed down quite a bit. And, I mean, props to the Duhawk defense.
Like Adam said, the Storm looked good in that first half. All 14 of their points came in that first quarter. As the Duhawk defense made some good adjustments and shut them out so far with 2 minutes left to go. And Jensen brought down by 3 Duhawks as Coach Halminiak's going to burn a timeout. I believe Sean Doyle was the first one there for the Duhawks, joined by Gemolo and Clark. Gemolo, Clark, and Doyle were the 3 Duhawks there for that sack as Halminiak called his second of 3 timeouts with 2:02 left to go here in the half. Interesting to see if the Storm, I'd have to assume they'd still run the passes here with 2:02 left to go, and they still have 2 timeouts if they run the ball here. Coach Halminiak can still call a timeout. Still call timeout with a lot of time left. A loss of 8 on the sack there for the Storm, making the 2nd and 18 from their own 17-yard line. Hayes is the running back there with Jensen as Jensen gets this one out quick to Statska, who is knocked out of bounds after a quick gain. Third and 11 for the Storm now. As going out of bounds, stop the clock. Which, if they don't pick up this first down here, could prove beneficial for the Duhawks. Jensen dropping back out to his left, and that ball is short and incomplete. Bring up a 4th down. And Coach Halminiak only had to use one of the 2 remaining timeouts, so 1:52 left to go in this half, and the Duhawks still have 1 timeout. That is plenty of time in college football.
Oh, yeah.
With the clock stopping to be spotted after a 1st down.
Absolutely, and I mean, just fantastic coverage there from Mikey Barber on the pass, not making it easy for the Simpson receiver. And now 3rd punt of the contest.
As there is Damani Brown back there to return it for the Duhawks. Draper's punt is away. Another spiraling one, and Brown's going to fair catch this one. Duhawks will be taking over from their own 41-yard line as they look to put up a score here. And bad news for the Duhawks, as it looks like Brock Couch's game is done, as he has ice on his right ankle and he's on crutches on the sideline. The freshman looks like he will be done for the day out of Tarpon Springs.
I mean, you didn't see Couch early in the year, but later in the season we saw him and we were saying his name quite a bit.
Really made a name for himself in that Wartburg game towards the end of it.
Yes, he did. Definitely going to be a huge receiver for the Duhawk offense in his upcoming years.
Crawford motion across the line of scrimmage as England drops back. Drops this one off to two-way Kaysen, who is brought down after a gain of 3 yards there. As the Duhawks getting plays in now, as we have reached 1:30 left to go in this half. -25 on the play clock as Kaysen motions over England. Dropping back, gets this one out quick. He's rushed and throws that to Crawford just over that back shoulder. As Crawford couldn't come down with that one, England overthrew him just a little bit there with the defender coming down in his face. Third and seven now for the Dewhawks on their own 44-yard line. Dewhawks need to go 56 yards and a minute 14 here to get up the score before half. As England get this one out quick to Haynes, who picks up the first down and wisely gets out of bounds.
Yep. Smart, that's a good placement there from England to allow Haynes to even get out of bounds that quickly too.
Dewhawks are now on the Storm's 47-yard line. Looking to put up another score. England dropping back. He's pressured. Evades the first defender. Dumps this one off to Jaheim Haynes once again. And Jaheim picks up the first down and then some. As the Dewhawks are hurrying now. With 59 seconds to go and counting. England, one step drop back. He's going to Monty Brown, who catches it. Yahtzee, touchdown, Dewhawks. Monty Brown's fourth touchdown reception in the first half ties him for the most receiving touchdowns in a game for a Dewhawk in program history. Have yourself a half, Damani Brown.
Yeah, four touchdowns in the first half. Just, I mean, ridiculous stats for Monty for sure. And again, just another beautiful thrown ball from England.
Yeah.
Finding his go-to guy.
As that reception may have put Brown over 200 yards receiving in the half, we'll have to wait for that officially. Mm-hmm. As you hear Coach Helminiak not overly happy about something. Oh, I was wrong. Damani Brown is officially at 197 receiving yards. I was awfully close, as here is the replay of Brown's fourth touchdown of the game. And just beat his defender and blew right past him. That was probably his easiest touchdown of today.
Yeah, oh yeah. Didn't have to leave the ground, just right in the breadbasket.
Looked like that was number 39, Isaac Oswald, on the coverage there. Ooh, a freshman covering him there. That wouldn't be a matchup that I would want.
Yeah, freshman. That's a very tough task you're being assigned right there in Damani Brown.
Dewhawks going for a two-point conversion here to get them up to 49 points. England drops back and throws that one to Haynes, and yeah. Haynes got held there on the coverage, and Dewhawks will get another go at it. Looks like that was Oswald again on the coverage there. So we're replaying the two-point conversion try. Brown has came out of the game here. Libby, Haynes, and Crawford are the receivers. Kaysen cuts this one in for the two-point conversion. Kaysen, good patient carry there. As you see him celebrating with his good body, Damani Brown. As Kaysen now has a touchdown and a two-point conversion. As you'll see here, the lane just, the whole developing, Kaysen being a patient runner.
Yes.
And cutting that one back, staying on his feet.
Again, I mean, patient is a perfect word for that. Like you said, allowing the hole to open up and just a beautiful cutback.
As there you see the fat heads for number 98, the defensive lineman, Emmett Finn, right there in the stands. as that two-point conversion puts the Duhawks up 49-14. 35-point lead now for the Duhawks.
Mm-hmm.
Talmadge kicking this one away from the left hash to Alexander, who's going to return this one at the 10-yard line. Alexander hit hard by who else but Nico Gemolo. Having himself a day.
Yeah, he is. Absolutely. I mean, saying his name quite a bit. And, again, only the first half, and we're saying his name a ton.
Yeah. Only a sophomore, so Duhawk fans have two more years to watch Nico play.
Yes.
And only get better. Jensen and Hayes in the backfield for the Storm. Jensen dropping back. Looking at this one out to Staska, who no good. He caught it out of bounds. Bringing up second down and 10. As Jensen was awfully confused by that. I heard him say, what?
Mm-hmm.
Second and 10, 38 seconds left to go in the half. Jensen dropping back. He's looking to throw this one deep down the field into about four guys. And Johnson with the interception for the Duhawks. Johnson looking to take this one down the right field. And he's looking for that hit almost, it looked like, as Rashad Johnson with
the interception
for the Duhawks. Rashad Johnson, the senior, with the interception. If it does stand up, which I believe it will.
Yeah, the Duhawk offense coming out on the field.
Rashad Johnson with interception. Here's the replay. Jensen kind of hurried that one into Duhawk coverage. That is the second interception of the game, 15 of the year. A lot of discussion going on here. I'm getting word that there are two flags down, so that could be what is being discussed.
There are two fouls, one by each team.
Oh.
During the return, personal foul, blindside block, number four. After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness on Simpson, number 76. Both fouls will be enforced.
Okay, so if both personal fouls are enforced, and they're both 15 yards. How can you enforce it? Ryan, my producer, is saying that we got the interception, but I'm just thinking out loud here. As the Duhawks have 25 seconds now. As the ball will be spotted where Johnson was brought down after the interception. JB with the handoff here. Ooh, nice little spin move. Staying on his feet.
Oh.
JB breaking this one free. JB brought down past the 50-yard line. And it looks like the Duhawks may just elect to run this one out after that one, as Coach Helminiak has not used that timeout as the Duhawks hurry here. Oh, because he went out of bounds. That's why he didn't use it. Sorry, as they hand this one off. Excuse me, England keeps it on the read option. England, first down. England cuts this one back, and he's got nothing but green turf in front of him. Yahtzee, touchdown, Duhawks. As England already adds to his stellar rushing and passing day with another touchdown. There you see JB ready to celebrate with the fellas. As here is England's rush.
Got you on the fake handoff
they
there.
They did get me on the fake handoff, as I believe unofficially in my head that looked like it was a 39-yard rush.
Mm-hmm.
For the touchdown. That'll be England's second rush of over 30 yards today. And both 30-plus yard rushes have been touchdowns for him as the Dewhawks score in 19 seconds. Talmadge's kick is up, and it is good. Yeah. Giving the Dewhawks a 56-14 lead with 6 seconds left to go in the half.
Yeah, I mean, just a fantastic run from England, and you said it, an unbelievable first half. Form nonetheless, not even game, just first half for England. And again, just great blocks and able to work his way through the defense and get just all sorts of daylight in front of him to find the end zone.
As there you see one happy fan in the stands, and surprised more people aren't standing up on the bleachers right now. That's dedication right there.
Yeah,
that's school spirit. We love to see that. Talmadge leg might be getting a little tired after all these kickoffs, as he's a way to do it once again. As this kick is away, it looks like Rankins will be the one to return it this time. He's at the 20. Cuts this one up, and he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. As that is the end of the first half. And after 30 minutes of game time, your Loras College Dewhawks 56, Simpson Storm 14. And Adam, what are some of your highlights from this first half?
I mean, start with the Storm. I mean, in the first quarter, it looked like there was going to be back and forth pretty much this entirety of this game, with Jensen and Worth really finding their roles and getting hot early. And then, obviously, the Dewhawks, England and Monty Brown. Stellar performances out of both of them. We just saw another touchdown, rushing touchdown for England, and I wouldn't be surprised if they keep it up just a little bit more going into the second half.
Yeah, like Adam said, we just saw that rush from England. It was a 60-yard touchdown rush. So England, 161 yards on the ground, 275 in the air with 7 total touchdowns. We got 20 minutes on the clock for halftime. Stay tuned for the second half. Hello and welcome back to the Rock Bowl. Once again, I'm Hugh Maloney, and joining me is Adam Rodriguez. Coming back, we got about 4:50 left till we start. Score 56-14. We actually got some first half highlights for you all here. Starting off here in the first quarter is Evan England's rush for the touchdown to get the Dewhawks offense started.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, we mentioned it when it happened. A great block there for Monty Brown. Allow that defender not to catch up to England, but fantastic blocks on that run.
As here's the interception by Ivers that we're talking about. Sports Center top 10 right there, possibly, as we throw this one up. After the interception, the Dewhawks, Monty Brown got a receiving touchdown, his first of the day. And that right there is a two-point conversion as Simpson responds back now, getting a touchdown from Jensen to Worth. As here we have another touchdown here for the Dewhawks, and who else
but Monty.
That man, Monty Brown, his again second of the day.
Just a pure athlete right there, able to get up and grab that one out of this Storm defender's hand and then just drag in the second defender into the end zone.
Yeah, and after Brown got his second touchdown of the game, Worth said that looks like fun and decided to do it himself right here on this play. As he goes up over the Dewhawk defender, running that one in for his second touchdown of the game.
Yeah, and right there, we thought it was going to be an offensive battle back and forth, after, especially after that huge bomb to Worth.
Yeah, and this right here was Kaysen's big touchdown rush, his first of the season. That was a 36-yard touchdown rush, as you see him nothing but happy right there. And that was all only in the first quarter. As we go to the second quarter now, as England gets it off quick to Crawford for a touchdown.
And again, and Happen mentioned it, a gritty play there from Crawford to find the end zone, breaking a couple tackles. He was doing everything in his power to find that end zone.
Yeah, as the Duhawks went for two that play, and they did not get it, as this was the amazing catch by Damani Brown.
Yeah.
Don't up, bobble it. Oh, catch it. Come on now. As Damani Brown, the big catch there, cementing his amazing game as, once again, throw it up to Damani Brown. It's about an 80% chance he'll come down with the ball, and he does right there, as the Duhawks did go for two after this, and they converted it, as here is another one to Damani Brown, his fourth on the day, tying the all-time game record for the Duhawks. And here's a two-point conversion. Kaysen, patient runner, cutting it back and finding the hole for the touch and a two-point conversion. And this here was Jensen's second interception of the game. It's really a matter of what Duhawk would come down with it, and it was Rashad Johnson. And there were two personal foul plays here on this, and then that didn't affect the Duhawks,
however,
as right here, Evan England decides to keep it on the read option and run it back in for a touchdown, his second rushing touchdown of the game, his seventh total touchdown. Mm-hmm. And those were your first half highlights from Loras College here in Dubuque, Iowa. Adam, what are some of the stats that kind of stuck out to you?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, England, we're going to start with England on the rushing game. I mean, 161 rushing yards out of your quarterback. I mean, that's not too bad if I have to say so myself. But on top of that, his 275 yards in the air with five touchdowns in the air, and then the two rushing touchdowns as well. And then with Monty, 3 yards short of 200 in the first half.
Yeah.
197 receiving yards for him and four touchdowns, with his longest being 42. I mean, just a fabulous game out of the dynamic duo for this Duhawk offense. And then obviously in that first half too, I mean, Jensen and Worth looked good in that first quarter, and then we mentioned that their offense just slowed down quite a bit in the second, and props to the Duhawk defense for really not letting them get that offense rolling like they would have liked and like we thought was going to happen.
Yeah. And like you said, talking about Monty Brown, coming into today, he had 15 touchdowns on the season, receiving touchdowns, which sets him atop of the record books. And adding four onto that, he is just kind of running away with the Loras record book for single season receiving touchdowns. And then career-wise, coming into today, he had 28. So move that on up to 32 now. And by the way, this young man is only a junior.
Yes.
So he's got one more year left of playing football, which is very exciting
for
these fans and fans of football. There's followers of Loras College football out there.
Absolutely. I mean, exciting for the fans and exciting for the team. Again, him and England coming back for one more. It should be a very promising year for this Duhawk squad next season.
And like we mentioned, the Duhawks will finish off their season in Cedar Rapids at Coe College, taking on the Cohawks. Duhawks and Cohawks matchup.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's going to be a real tough matchup for them next week in their final game of the season.
Willis and Filoso back to return it for the Duhawks as the second half is officially underway. And Willis is going to return this one for the Duhawks. He's at the 20-yard line now as he cuts this one back up the field, and he's brought down short of the 25 as there's a late flag here, and the ball's for now spotted at the 24-yard line. We'll see if that changes after the flag. Oh, mic's not on, sir.
There you go. Blocking the back, number 95 of the receiving team. That penalty will be enforced from the end of the run, first down.
That one on the junior defensive lineman from New Orleans, Louisiana, Preston Petrusik. Guilty of the blocking back there. Like Adam stated, a great first half from England. 16 completions on 18 attempts for 275 yards and 5 passing touchdowns. So he looks to add to some of those stats here as he gets this one out. And actually, he's not going to get this one out. He's going to, now he will, to Harrison Willis. And H cuts this one back up for the first down. As the Duhawks moving the sticks off of one play.
Yeah, good poison, good patience there from England. Obviously had to scramble out to his right, and then Willis able to just get open, make it easy for England to find him, and like you said, just get that first down right out of the gate.
Shotgun formation now as Two-Way gets this ball here, and he's rumbling, bumbling, stumbling for a gain of 8 yards. As the Duhawks are going fast now, not allowing this Storm team to get set up here. England gets this out quick to Crawford as Crawford.
Ooh.
Close to the first. Oh, nope, excuse me. Stepped out of bounds. About a yard short, 2 yards short, third and two now.
Pass complete to Michael Crawford.
Shotgun formation. Brown is at the bottom of your screen. Next to him is Haynes. As the Duhawks get another offsides penalty and a free play here for England, as he's going to pick up the first down here for the Duhawks. So two times the Duhawks have gone on the hard count. They have been successful getting the offsides penalties. As we wait for the official call here from the official. I think it was on whether Coach Helminiak wanted to accept or decline the penalty.
On the defense, that penalty is declined. The result of the play, first down.
Coach Helminiak elects to decline the encroachment penalty, as it would have been a first down either way. Making this now a first and 10 on the Duhawks' own 39-yard line. England hands this one off to Kaysen, who stays on his feet after the initial defender, and Kaysen picks up the first down after being hit behind the line of scrimmage. The yards after contact, yak, is going up for Kaysen after that rush. Haynes, Brown, Willis, and Crawford are the receivers as Brown goes across the line of scrimmage. England forced to step up in the pocket. He's going to throw this one deep to Monty Brown, who is open, and Monty Brown makes a man miss. Yahtzee! Touchdown, Duhawks! And that is a new school record for receiving touchdowns in a game. That is 5 for Damani Brown, and new record. And, you know, me and Monty, you know, we talk every once in a while. And he Snapchatted me yesterday. He goes, I'm going to break another one tomorrow.
Yeah.
I go, what? He goes, I'm going to break another record. I go, which one? And then he just didn't tell me which one. I guess he told me now.
Yeah,
he's just letting the game speak for himself.
Tell you.
Yeah, he was waiting to tell me. Pretty impressive for Monty. Last week broke 2 records. This week broke 1.
A little short on throw there from England. It could be because he was a little pressured and off on the run there. But Monty,
kick is no good from Scott Talmadge, and he's had a little bit of a rough day here.
Yeah, he has.
But here is that play, and Adam, like you were talking about, ball a little underthrown, but England across the body.
Yep.
That's still one heck of a throw in.
But then to miss it right there, and yeah, I mean.
5 touchdowns for Cinco on the day. With 13 minutes left to go in the third quarter. And I'd be interested to see if Monty Brown's day is done after that one. as the Duhawks are up by 48 points here.
Yeah, I'll be interested to see what starters stay out there with the big lead that the Duhawks have.
Talmadge away to kick this one once again. And this one is going to be caught around the 5-yard line for the Storm as they're going to take this one up.
Ooh! Ooh!
Wow. He is hit hard by the Duhawks. Looks like there's multiple defenders there. Number 18, Jonah Irving, the first one to greet him. And then it looks like the one that delivered the hit for the Duhawks was Paul Rasp. And that was a big old hit right there.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, you could really hear the sound of the pads. Yes.
First and 10 now for the Storms. They hand this one off to Alexander, who falls forward for a yard. Second and 9 now for the Storm. The Storm getting in the play here. 15 on the game clock when they snap it. They're going to get this one out quick to Worth, who is knocked out of bounds by Zacchaeus Knighton.
Yeah, first time we've said his name in quite a while.
Mm-hmm.
Third three.
Bring up third down and 3 now for the Storm. As the Duhawk defense looks to get another stop. As it looks like England's day, if it's not already done, it will be done after the next drive perhaps, as Garrett Hutchinson is getting warmed up on the sideline.
Yep.
Jensen for the Storm, rolling out to his left. Throwing it towards the sideline. Intended target was Worth, and he overthrew him. Bring up fourth down, and the Storm is bringing out the punt team.
Yeah, Hutchinson, I think we will be seeing Hutch coming into the game.
As there he is right there on your screen. The senior quarterback. And something to note as well in terms of records. Receiving yards today, Damani Brown has 245. That puts him second in the record book for all time. Not all time, for single game receiving yards, excuse me. So Monty Brown sets a record and puts himself in second for the other one today. And his day is not done yet, as he was out there to return that ball. And it looks like he will stay out there. I mean, he broke 2 last week. Why not just keep, you know, keep the numbers, you know, even? You know, might as well go 2 and 2 today, right?
Yeah.
I mean, he's only 20 yards short.
20 yards short. To tie
and
it.
He's averaging 30 yards a catch today, so very well could happen as Hutch is in at quarterback with Britt at halfback. Storm looking like they're going to send pressure here. They got 6 on the line. They send 6 as a little bit of a bad snap here, and Storm saying they have it, and the Storm
do have it.
Tough first play there for the Duhawks coming out on that drive as they turn it over. And on the recovery for the Storm is number 47, Caleb Heidrich, the freshman from Mesa, Arizona. A lot of Arizona kids on this Storm team as we do have a replay. But maybe not yet is what I'm told as we come back here on first down and 10.
Yeah, I mean, on that, just there on that, it looked as if Hutch was already turned to hand the ball off to Two-Way before he even had it from the snap. And, oh!
As the Storm get awfully close to the end zone there, Bushy was the tight end there that brought that one down and knocked short of the goal line. As Jensen is going to throw this one to Jones, who is about a yard short of the first down. Rydberg made the touchdown saving tackle a couple plays ago for the Dewhawks.
Josh Rydberg on that tackle.
Second down and goal here from the Dewhawks 1 yard line. Storm under center now. They roll out and he's looking for his tight end. Bushy Jensen was, and he was pressured by Rydberg and Irving for the Dewhawks. Oh, excuse me, Phelps and Irving for the Dewhawks.
Again, I mean, the Dewhawks doing a fantastic job. Their red zone defense has been fantastic. Obviously, giving up those two long bombs, but in the red zone, the defense has just been stellar.
As there you see that Dewhawk defense that didn't allow a point in the second quarter. Trying to make a stand here on their own 1 yard line. Jensen hands this off to Hayes. Hayes brought down for a loss by the Dewhawks. Making the stop for the Dewhawks looks like that was Preston on the stop. As now, fourth and goal from the one has turned into fourth and goal from the two.
Fourth and goal for Simpson.
As the defense looks to make a stop here. It'd be their second goal line stop of the game as Worth motions across the line. Jensen was looking for him. He was covered. Yeah. Jensen backpedaling, throwing this one up.
Cool.
And that one incomplete. A risky ball thrown there. And coach, defensive coach Greg Bowers fired up for his defense.
Yeah, he is.
Made a great defensive stand, and he's loving it. Milo Collier, the senior, making the pressure there on Jensen. Been saying a lot of seniors today making some great plays.
Yes. I mean, that's what you want as your seniors. And then why not on senior day too? But your seniors, I mean, they're the top dog for a reason on the team. Lots of experience out of them. And obviously, they're Collier able to create that stop and now a turnover on down. And hopefully a different result here on the first snap of the second drive.
Hutchinson and JB in the backfield. They're going to hand this one off to Britt. JB bouncing this one back out. Hit hard. But he keeps going for a gain of looks like around 5 or 6 yards.
Jamel's red on the carry.
And Evan England's 6 touchdown passes today ties him second all time for single game passing touchdowns. Tied with Nick Schlott, Nolan Baumover, and Noah Sigworth. As JB gets another run here. Couple yards short of the first down. Making this third and one. Third and one for the Dewhawks on their 11-yard line. Hutchinson gets this one to Brown. Brown looking to break free from that one, but he could not. A good stop there by number 32, Juan Hernandez on Imani Brown. Hard to bring him down in. Single covers. Looks like Brown's day is done. Getting daps and hugs from his teammates as he comes off the field. As that reception ends Monty's day and extends the Dewhawk drive. Hutchinson out quick to Crawford. Crawford, stiff arm, stays on his feet down the sideline. Crawford, can he outrun him? It's a track race now. Crawford,
collar, no.
No horse collar as the fans want a flag. It looked like one.
Yeah, it did.
But not, you know, we're up high, so I know. But still, a big gain from Crawford nonetheless. Thought he was about to break free.
Yes, they did. Oh.
That's a long run. He's brought down the 17-yard line.
as you hear people asking about the horse collar. As Willis motions across the offensive line, there's a run to Jamel. Jamel's going nowhere after that one. Also, something to know along as terms of records coming in today, Evan England with 20 on the season for single season passing touchdowns. Puts him one behind the all-time record after today with 26. England needing two passing touchdowns next week to break the all-time record for the Duhawks. As this one is a ball to Crawford, and Crawford! Yahtzee, touchdown, Duhawks! Michael Crawford's second touchdown of the day, Garrett Hutchinson's first passing touchdown. You love to see that, Garrett Hutchinson's. I believe that's his first collegiate passing touchdown as well.
I believe so.
As he is backed up Sigworth when he first got here, and then Evan England. As that drive was really all Hutchinson and Crawford there. As the kick is up, and that one is good. As Ephraim Muntz was the one to kick that one in for the Duhawks. As here's the replay. And
yeah,
just that was a good ball right there. Yes. A back shoulder fade for the touchdown.
Yeah, a fantastic ball there and fantastic concentration from Crawford to come away with that one and able to stay in bounds too. And just a beautiful play and a great drive. After a huge, huge play from Crawford, why not reward him with the touchdown?
I like the way you're thinking, Adam, per usual. Talmadge kicking this one away after Muntz kicked in the extra point. That reception that Crawford had to get the Duhawks in the red zone, officially 67 yards as the Storm fair catch this one. We'll take it to 25. Yeah, 7:26 left to go here in the third quarter. Horse College Duhawks 69, Simpson Storm 14.
Nice.
Jensen still the quarterback. So they hand this one off to Hayes, who has a hole and is upended as he tries to jump over a couple of Duhawk defenders. The Storm looking to make the move here, as that was Michael Carney on the tackle for the Duhawks. Jensen throwing this one deep, and that ball underthrown. Mm. Looking for, really, the guy he's been targeting a lot today, Staskis.
Yes.
For the Storm. Staskis, only two receptions for 30 yards, but has been looked at a lot today. And then Worth being kind of shut down by the Duhawks. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the two touchdowns, one for 50 yards, but only 78 receiving yards besides... I mean, you take away the 150-yard touchdown reception, and
yeah,
he's not having that big of a day as Jensen throwing this one to Jones over the middle, who's got the first down.
Pass complete to Cameron Jones. That's good for Simpson, first down.
Jones, Staska, and Bickham are the receivers at the top of your screen. As Jensen drops back, he's going to throw this one over the middle. That one is intercepted by the Duhawks. and brought down just past the 35-yard line. That was number 21, Owen Kelly, the junior defensive back out of Chicago, Illinois, and St. Rita High School with the interception. As here is the replay, Jensen hit a little bit as he throws, but that ball was underthrown by about 4 yards there as the Duhawk offense, which has been hot, so hot that I got to tell you about another record that may be coming up here. The Duhawks currently have 69 points, which is tied for third most points they've ever scored. Second most points they've scored is 73, and then the first most they've scored is 82.
That came back in 1912.
1912 against the University of Wisconsin-Platteville. And, yeah, that'd be kind of crazy if we saw the Duhawks break a record from 1912.
Yeah, that would be pretty awesome.
It was. That would be. It's about 100 and, let's say, 11 years old. Don't check the math on that one as they hand this one off to, I believe that was Kaysen. And checking in at halfback is Xander George, the sophomore running back from Rock Island. As there is the sophomore from Rock Island on your screen, JB and Two-Way coming out of the game. As George motions out wide, Hutchinson alone in the backfield as the Storm looks like they're going to send pressure. Duhawk offense picks it up well, and Hutchinson finds his favorite target, Michael Crawford, for the first down.
Hutchinson pass complete to Michael Crawford. That's good for Duhawk first down.
First and 10 for the Duhawks as there's number 12, QB1 for the Loras College Duhawks. Evan England watching his teammates go on and try to get some more points here as Owen Libby gets it here for close to the first down as you hear the sideline erupt with the Libby chants. Second and 4 here, 6-yard reception from Hutchinson to Libby. George with the run here. It's a gain of 2, making this third and about 2.
George on the carry.
As Libby comes out of the game, and coming in for him is Hunter Guyon. Third and 2, the Storm telling their players to watch the ball. Oh, little miscommunication there. Hutchinson and George went the wrong way, but Hutchinson going to improvise and use those legs for a first down. As Hutchinson turned left and George went right there on that play. About the second miscommunication we've seen there.
Yes.
This handoff is to George as not much going on there. A couple of Duhawks get a pancake down the field on a Simpson Storm player. I believe that was number 66, my good friend Cato Hare. In on that one down the field. Second and 9 for the Duhawks. As Hutchinson, that ball is hit out of his hand as he threw it. And that could have been bad for the Duhawks. And before that play, the Duhawks total offense, 736, which puts them second for a single game record with 736 yards. In that first place spot is 797 yards that the Duhawks had against the University of Wisconsin Stout back in 2015. Hutchinson dropping back, finds a man,
going down the sideline. That is number 80, Drew Randle. Drew Randle for the touchdown.
Oh, my
God. Everybody's getting in on this scoring. Yahtzee, touchdown, Duhawks. Everybody's getting in on the scoring today, as there's Evan England right there. Drew Randle, the sophomore wide receiver from Algonquin, Illinois.
Yeah, Crawford picking him up on his shoulders, taking him through the team there.
As the Duhawks have now jumped into second, the second most points they've ever scored in program history right now, 75, as Ephraim goes to kick this one up and through the uprights, as here is a replay with Randle scoring a touchdown. I mean, that's just determination right there.
That's grit. That's a lot of grit out of him there.
A high motor.
Yeah, huge motor for him.
Hail, Loris Varsity. I look at, there is Caden on the swim team right there. I'm on a first name basis with Caden, not a last name basis, so I would like to get the last name in there, but I just can't. As it looks like there is a Storm player down on the field. That is number 43, Alex Boyle, the junior out of Peoria, Arizona.
Yeah, it doesn't look like he can put a lot of pressure on one of those legs. Hopefully nothing too serious for him. Always hate to see that from any player if you can't put any pressure down on a leg.
Rankin and Jared Fisher back to return this. Fisher listed as a quarterback out of Des Moines, Iowa, and Hoover. He's back there to return this ball with Rankin.
Bold strategy, see if it pays off for him.
As he's going to fair catch this one, and he'll get the ball at the 25-yard line.
First catch for number 10, Jared Fisher.
As 2 minutes and 27 seconds left to go here in the third quarter, and the Storm are coming out looking to put some points up on the board. As they still remain scoreless from the second quarter and into this one. They hand this one off to Rankin, and that one is going to go nowhere. A minute 55 left to go here in the third quarter as the Storm motion a man into the flat and looking to make a man miss, and he does not do that, as that is Rankin on the reception. Nixon,
yeah, good
making
tackle.
The stop there. There's another good tackle there by Michael Mixon.
Michael Mackman on the tackle from Duhok.
Go line! Come on, line!
Jensen still in at the quarterback position. Hayes is the running back. Jensen gets it. He's looking for Staskis, who hits him on the comeback route and is knocked out of bounds by Mikey Barber. As looks like a close to the first down marker. It'll be fourth and inches. At least I think. Oh, actually, they're going to move the sticks.
Hey, Busy first down.
So the officials initially said it was fourth down. They ultimately decide to move the sticks, giving the Storm a first down. As Jensen is going to hand this one off, as Barber gives out a big hit there, coming down from his cornerback position. And for the first time today, we'll be seeing Nile Piscasio with the run here, the junior from Oak Park, Illinois. As we may be approaching the last play of the third quarter. 10 seconds left to go here. They don't have to run a play, but they do, as Jensen hands this one off to Pasquio once again. And this one, a much less gain than the last one, which will be the last play of the third quarter. And at the start of the fourth, the Storm will have a third and two. And after the third quarter, Lord Scott's Duhok 76, Simpson Storm 14. And Adam, this Duhok defense has just been clicking on all cylinders.
Yes, they sure have. I mean, we've been talking about the offense so much, obviously, with all the records and everything being broken and possibly being broken. But, yeah, the defense, I mean, giving up the early touchdowns in the first, and then they've just been locked down ever since, not allowing anything to get going for the Storm, and just shutting down the run game pretty good, and obviously shutting down the passing game as well. Not letting Worth get hot like we thought he was going to. We saw him get a couple receptions early in that first.
8-5-0 is the winning ticket.
Oh, and the 50-50 also just went out as well at the end of the quarter. So somebody could have a very happy day if they're a Duhok fan, as well as, you know, Duhok win, and you know, win the 50-50. As the Storm are coming out looking to put up a score here. They hand this one off to Hayes. Hayes looking a little bit fresh now. Takes that one past the 50-yard line. Looks like it'll be marked at the 48 of the Duhawks.
Get for first down.
Hayes checked out of the game. I believe Bickham has checked in for him. And then in at halfback is Pasquio. They hand it off to him as he's bouncing this one out to the left for no gain, the line judge says.
Pasquio on the carry.
So there's a player, offensive lineman, down on the field for the Storm. It's number 70, Cole Heinrichs, the senior offensive lineman from Marion, Iowa. As Heinrichs is able to get up and able to walk off the field mostly on his own power. Looks like that left leg is limping. And Garrett Hutchinson, in that third quarter, 149 passing yards with two touchdowns. It's not too bad for single quarter. And as Jensen is going to throw this one deep, and that one is incomplete.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I thought Worth came down with that one. That would have been one heck of a catch, but good coverage by Zacchaeus Knighton.
Yeah, great coverage from Knighton. I mean, just kind of step by step. Knighton was with them, and then yeah, I agree. I totally thought Wirth came down with it as well. But Knighton, obviously, the coverage is just too good there.
Third and 10 now. 14 minutes on the dot left to go in the game as Jensen rolls out to his right, throws this one on the run. That pass broken up once again by Zacchaeus Knighton. Zah had those two early PI calls. Bouncing back from it now as he's had a great game after that. As you saw him hit the seatbelt strap celebration, signifying that he is all over his man. As Draper is way to kick this away. And Filoso, I believe, is to turn it back for the Duhawks. As a little bit of a low snap here. He's going to fair catch this one. Ooh. Caught that one a little high off the pads, but it doesn't matter as he, you know, still caught it. As out comes the Duhawk offense once again. Garrett Hutchinson looking to add to his 149 passing yards on just six attempts in this quarter. We'll see how much Coach Halmaniak allows. As they, I believe, just announced Damani Brown breaking the record on the speakers in the stadium as the crowd all celebrate. We got a little bit of a rugby style push going on here, and literally everybody is involved in this except for two players, and man, that was intense.
Xander George, scrum on a carry.
Xander George got the first down there, and a good job the offensive line as they pushed him there for the first down. It looks like a Storm player is hobbling off the field here. That would be number 48, Jackson Carlson. First and 10 here as George gets another run after that first down run. He's bouncing this one out to the right side. He runs over a man and picks up the first down, but there is a flag on the play. George lowering the shoulder there. As we get the official call, it looks like it's on the Duhawks.
Holding on the offense, number 54.
Number 54 for the Duhawks is Tyson Smith, the junior offensive lineman out of Morrison, Illinois, with the hold call there. Shotgun formation, Hutchinson and George in the backfield. George is going to get this one. He's blown up behind the line of scrimmage by the Storms, number 97, Jeremiah Garland. Making the stop there, making this a second and 17 for the Duhawks. Storm starting to really approach that line of scrimmage here. Low snap here. Hutchinson's going to throw it over the middle to Harrison Wiss, who dives but is unable to pull that one in. Ball just led a little bit out in front of him.
We love the effort there from Willis. Trying to go out and grab it and make a huge play and, I mean, just keep the energy so alive.
Yeah. As now it is third and 17 for the Duhawks on their own 19-yard line. Brian Filoso is checked in the game. Randall Willis, other receivers with George in there as well. They hand this one off to George. And George, uppercut. Nasty spill there. And that looked extremely painful. As the official is down right now. As the official gets some applause from the crowd as he gets up after that one.
Yeah,
gotta
I mean,
give him some props.
Yeah, big time. Scary there for the official because those dudes are not coming in slow at all.
There he is right there on your screen. That's the official that is the most in the action, as well as they're the ones in the middle of the field and all the players. And this first punt for the Dewhawks today. And it's going to take a Dewhawk bounce and go at the 30-yard line. And on that punt was Daniel Justu. First time we've said his name today. As there's a very late flag that was just thrown. The officials just dropped it down there right now. I'm going to try to guess what's going on right now.
Yeah.
But all I can tell you is that they're talking to Coach Hominiak right now, as you can see on your screen.
Illegal substitution on the kicking team. That penalty is declined. First down. Correction, it was on the receiving team.
.11:48 left to go here in this game. Pascasio is the back in for the Storm as he's looking to bounce this one out to the right, and he's hit hard after the cut.
Niall Pascasio on the carry.
Dewhawks still have some of their top two cornerbacks in the game with Mikey Barber and Rashad Johnson. Johnson, like we showed, coming back from halftime with the interception. That was Jensen's third interception of the game. They hand this one off to Pascasio once again. And slowly but surely, he's getting closer to that first down marker as we come up on third down. And don't stand, the ball is out, but I believe Pascasio was down before then, as it is now third and four for the Storm as Pascasio comes out of the game. And Haynes comes in. Jensen and Hayes in the backfield. Jensen gets this one out quick, right by the sticks for the first down. That's Cole Staska.
Yeah, again, you did mention it. Saying Stauskas' name a lot in this game, and, I mean, props to the Duhawk defense shutting down Worth. I mean, they looked for Worth here and there, but we saw great coverage with Knighton on him on the long ball. That was no good, but just a fantastic adjustment for the Duhawks to shut down Worth.
As Worth is at the bottom of your screen in that bunch there, as they hand this one off to Hayes, who makes the first man miss, but then can't get past the other two from the Duhawks, as that was number 92, Max Turlap, the sophomore, making the stop. Second and 8 now for the Storm. They hand this one off to Hayes once again, who is driven backwards by the Duhawks.
Well, Hayes on a carry.
Michael Carney with the tackle. Jensen once again, deep drop back here. Gets it out right by the sticks. And they're going to say that one was caught.
What a grab.
Good reception there from once again Cole Staska. Oh, line judge got overruled, so it will be incomplete. Keeping this one 4th and 9. As out comes the punt team for the Storm.
Yeah, I mean, again, just the Duhawk defense doing just everything and anything to not let Simpson get anything. Even with their second and third string guys in there. I mean, it's a very strong, pretty deep Duhawk defense, and we're seeing it today.
That was a good punt, and Floessi was told to let that one go into the back of the end zone, and great punt there from Draper. Yeah,
very good punt.
With 8:16 left to go, there on your screen is the offensive line, and head coach Steve Helminiak talking to him, as he is also the offensive line coach, as well as obviously the head coach. Hunter Guyon in at tight end for the Duhawks, as Hutch hands this one off to George. George, a lot of running room in him. He's running hard right now.
Very hard.
Xander George out of carry.
Looks like they're going to mark him a couple inches short here. Second down. Storm sending pressure here as Hutchinson just throws that one out of bounds over Hunter Guyon. Third and inches now as the clock has stopped with 7:49 left to go in the game. As Hutchinson's going to throw this one to Randall, who does not catch it, but the Duhawks once again got another free play with the offside or encroachment.
Offside on the defense, number 47. 5-yard penalty results in the first down.
Caleb Heidrich called for the offsides, giving the Duhawks a first down. as it has gotten a little bit chillier here since kickoff, as George gets the handoff here, stays on his feet after the initial contact. George,
ooh,
a little bit of a spin
move.
Oh, yeah. Want to add that one to the mixtape highlight reel. Okay, I respect it. Speaking of it getting a little bit chillier, Adam, could that play some factor in some Duhok events that are coming up on the Rock Bowl after?
Oh, absolutely. Today? I mean, right after this, you get the women's soccer game in the ARC mm-hmm. championship, and following them is the men's mm-hmm. soccer team also in the ARC championship game. I mean, the women's soccer team, they are going to take on the Simpson Storm as well. Simpson ranked number 2 in this tournament, and I mean, just another fantastic mm-hmm. year for this women's soccer team here at Loras. It's been super exciting to watch them. It was a super good game against the rivals down the street, but I can't wait for that one at 5 mm-hmm. o'clock. And then as for the men, also just another fantastic season for them. Also the one seed, so both soccer teams, the one seed.
As Hutchinson, real quick, just gets that throw out there to number 87, Bennett Sirens.
And, I mean, the men, they take on Wartburg. Again, two seed in the tournament as well. That's going to be a super exciting one, too. The men's team did take on Wartburg earlier in the year and did take it 2-0. And women also did play Simpson earlier and also won theirs 2-0. So they've got the number over their opponents tonight. And hopefully both teams can come out and find their way into the national tournament.
Yep. As George gets another handoff here, he's been getting a lot of work in here this quarter. As it looks like a Storm player is down, that's number 97, Jeremiah Garland, slow to get up. As he's coming out of the game now. As Hutchinson's going to give this one to George once again. Who is a couple yards short of the first down, making this 3rd and 2. Coming into the game. The bench was loving it. Number 32, Rowan Carlson, the freshman running back out of Tripoli, Iowa, as there is a Duhok down on the field. Looks like that's George. It looks like that's Xander George down on the field. As his left shoe is off and he's getting helped off the sideline here. Hutchinson is going to hand this one off to Carlson, who is going to be, they're going to give him the first down there on the handoff. As Hutchinson's day is done, a great performance by him. And coming in at quarterback is number 4, Max Glombeski. As they hand this one off once again here to Carlson. And then now another single game record that was broken was total offense today. The Duhawks are currently at 806 yards, which gives them a 9-yard lead on the previous record, and that will only build here as Carlson gets another run. And we'll see if we're going to let Max Glombeski throw the ball here.
Carlson
Max, the lefty, looking to throw this one deep to Randall, and he finds him, just drops it in the breadbasket. Yahtzee, touchdown, Duhawks.
That is Max's first collegiate touchdown pass, and he's fired up. I mean, just dropped that thing right in the breadbasket to Randall, his second of the game. And the Duhawks, if this extra point goes through, will be the most points that they have scored in program history, breaking a 111-year record right here. Ephraim Muntz to kick it away. Oh, and it got blocked as the Storm are going to pick this one up, and Hutchinson's got to make a tackle to stop him here as the Storm are going down the sideline.
My God.
The Storm are going to get the 2 points here, making this an 82-16 game.
As they're awfully excited about that, as you heard on the mic.
Very excited about that 2 points.
That might be the most nonchalant bomb that I've ever heard dropped on a event. Because that was number 24, Gabriel Williams, with the 2-point conversion score there. And, oh, I was really looking forward to see 83 go up there. But, hey, tied the record.
Tied the record. 111 years. That's all it took.
Yeah,
all it took.
Only took the Cubs 108 to win the World Series, so, I mean, that's nothing. As there you see the scoreboard right there. There's all those points that have been scored today by the Duhawks. So here's Evan England rushing for a touchdown earlier in the game. And that was the first touchdown of the game for the Duhawks. As Talmadge kicks this one away. And the Storm will take over from the 25-yard line. With 3:53 left to go here from the Rock Bowl. As they motion here, and that one, brought down right at the line of scrimmage for the Storm. That was Bickham on the run there.
Kevin Bickham on the carry.
Second and 10 now for the Storm. As Jensen rolls out to his right, and that's Worth. First time he's, I believe, caught a pass in this half. Gets the Storm closer to the first down marker. Third and 6 now. 4. The Storm, the scoreboard says third down, and the marker on the field says second. But I'm seeing the line judge saying it's third down.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go. They got it figured out. As Big Kim motions across the line of scrimmage, Jensen getting this one out quick to Starska, who is, looks like they're going to give him the first down as that moves the chains. As we're now approaching 2 minutes left in this game, the Storm are on the Duhawks 35-yard line. Low snap here. Jensen handles it well as Ooh, good run here from nice Pascasio. Staying on his feet. And throwing off a nice stiff arm, Derrick Henry-esque.
Yes.
As there you see some of those front four from the Dewhawks. Number 98 right there. You saw his cut out of his head earlier in the game. Emmett Finn in the stands. Pascasio and Jensen are in the backfield. Three receivers at the bottom of your screen. And this one off to Pascasio once again, who picks up the first down and will be brought down at the 48-yard line. First and 10 now for the Storm. A minute 13 and counting left to go here in this one. It's been an action-packed game. Dewhawks with 82 points, the Storm with 14. Total of 96. As they hand this one off to Pascasio, one for 2-yard gain. And the fans are happy. Players fired up. That was number 58, Luke Bolstead, with the stop there. And I was talking to, I mentioned how I'm friends with Cade O'Hare. I was talking to him yesterday coming out of class. And he was saying that the Dewhawks could possibly put up close to 100 points. And they were awfully close.
Pretty close.
So I got to give I got to give props to Cade. He was pretty close on his assessment.
I mean, offense had was just clicking on all
this
cylinders.
Ball is oh, that is intercepted by the Dewhawks. That is number 8, Jacob Sanchez. Sanchez making a play out there with 13 seconds left to go in the game. Sanchez gets his first interception, and Jensen throws his fourth of the game. As Jensen got up pretty high for the ball, we'll see it here. Not Jensen, excuse me. Sanchez got up well for the ball. And, yep, you could just kind of see the frustration there from Staska.
Yep.
As that would not be. As, hey, there's our great camera worker right here. That's Nora. And then next to her is Dave. And you guys have been doing great today.
Yeah, fantastic.
I just want you guys to know that. And then
there's us right
there. This is Adam right here. And I'm Hugh. Freshly shaven head. Shaved that this year. Thank you. And that will be the end of this game with the knee being taken. The Dewhawks, 82. Simpson Storm, 16. And that has been the senior day. And Adam, that has been my time, and that has been your time, calling Loras College football.
Yeah, it's been a blast. It was a super fun season. Absolutely. What a good one to go out on.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
It's been a great 4 years for me. I really enjoyed it. Made a lot of friends through it.
Yes.
It's been just a lot of fun. I've really enjoyed it. But that has been all. And goodbye. For now and probably forever, Loras College Dewhawk football fans. Hugh Maloney signing out for Adam Rodriguez and Jill Speck and Do Media. Stay safe, everybody.
There we go, folks.